Ah, I will smack you around my garden. What is that? Is that a June bug? Huh? You don't like June bugs. He doesn't like June bugs. We've been digging up the soil here today, and we're finding a lot of June bugs, and that's okay. Normally June bugs, you need to get them out of your soil because they make those big, white, ugly, gooey grubs that eat the roots of your plants. And June bugs are little brown, actually large brown insects. They look like a little Volkswagen, and they fly pretty much like a Volkswagen too. They're not good bugs, and those go directly to the chickens because chickens love June bugs and they love their grubs. So it's a win-win situation. I find bugs, chickens get to eat, everybody's happy, except the June bugs. And today we are planting ambrosia corn. Ambrosia is a close relative of what's called bodacious. Bodacious is a hybrid, and I don't mind growing hybrid corn because I'm not saving the seed anyway. I change corn whenever I get a mood. I don't save the seed, and I don't feel a need to grow heirloom corn. A lot of people only grow heirlooms. I grow what I like, and sometimes that's a hybrid, sometimes that's an heirloom. It all depends on what I want. And today I'm going to be planting corn, but I wanted to bring you along because I want to show you how I grow corn. My way of growing corn is a little bit different. Most people will first of all, I rototilled this out with a little tiller, which gave me a backache because it's a piece of crap. And then I took this thing, and I'm sure it has a name, but I really don't care. I just call it that pointy thing. And I brought it all into rows, and I hilled up the dirt. And I have 5 rows right here. Normally, you would plant corn on the top of the hill, and I don't know why. There's got to be a good reason, and I'm sure the farmers know, and I'm sure everybody else out there knows except me. I really don't care to plant it on top. My method is I dig a trench, I plant it in the trench. And my reasoning for that is when you see corn growing, no matter how you plant it, when it comes up, you'll see these roots that are coming out of the stem and going down. And you can bring dirt up onto that. So what I'm doing is I'm planting in the trench. The corn is gonna sprout, roots are gonna go down. Then as it grows, you're gonna see those roots. Then I'm gonna bring the soil in from the sides and pile it up, and it'll eventually be on a hill. But until then, I'm gonna grow it in the trenches. It makes it a lot easier to water too. All I gotta do is water inside the trench. Normally watering corn is a pain because you water in the trench and you don't know if it got up to the corn, and it's a mess, you know? I'm trying to make some kind of scientific reasoning out of it, but I really have none. I just plant my corn a little bit different. So you're gonna come along for the ride this year, and let's find out if Ray can grow corn all the way to having ears of corn. And somebody sent me a few seeds. His channel is Douglas Fire, I believe. I don't know. I'll put a link in the description. He used to do gardening until he got evicted from his place, which was really kind of a sad thing. But he's doing the best that he can right now. But he sent me what's called glass gem corn seeds. He only sent me a few because he didn't have very many to spare. I'm going to plant those and see if I can grow ears of that. And if it does form ears, I want to show you what glass gem corn looks like. It is a work of art. It is an absolute work of art. Anyway, enough talk. Let's start planting some seeds, shall we? Now, when you get corn seeds, sometimes it'll come yellow, sometimes it'll come red. And I believe they treat this to keep the fungus off or something like that. I don't really care. Anyway, when I plant them about a foot apart, and I put 3 seeds per area. And the reason I do that is because sometimes they don't germinate. And it depends on your soil temperature, what's going on, if there's any kind of varmints around eating the stuff. But when you plant corn, you want to make sure that the soil is warm. So when you dig it up, you put your hand down in there. And if it feels like gently cool or room temperature, it's perfect. Corn you can plant early, but what happens is with cool temperatures, sometimes the seed rots in the ground. So if you plant early thinking you're going to get a jump on the season, you're not, because the corn needs warm temperatures to germinate. So planting later actually is better than planting earlier. Strange, huh? But anyway, 3 seeds, skip a foot, 3 seeds, skip a foot, 3 seeds. And if all of them germinate, or more than one germinates, I let the first one that comes up survive, and the other 2, they get yanked out and fed to the chickens, because I want the strongest one to start out. So 3, 3, 3, and that's all there is to it. I'm going to continue planting this, and then I'll come back to you when I'm done. Before I cover up the corn, I'm going to go through and give them a nice moistening, not a soaking, just a moistening, to make sure that the soil around them is moist. And the reason I do this is because if I cover them up with dirt, you never know if the water is going to soak in. You know, sometimes when you water, you think that the plants are really well watered, and then you dig down about an inch or so and oops, it's dry. This way I can be sure that the seeds are in contact with moist soil, and it gives me the best possible chance of germination. I'm going to moisten them first, and then I'm going to go through and cover them up with just a little bit of soil, enough to hide them from the birds, because let me tell you, the birds around here are just dying to pick these seeds up out of the ground. Not going to happen in my garden. And I want to make sure that I don't water these too hard, because I don't want to wash the seeds all over the place and have them floating together, and then have a clump of corn coming up in one area and no corn in the other area. You don't really know what's going on. Done. Now let's cover it up. Okay. Hey, Vascovet. Okay. Corn is watered, just a tiny bit of soil. Don't really need to bury them that deep, because we're going to be bringing up soil later on. So I'm just going to give them about maybe an inch of soil to make sure they're covered up. A little bit from each side. I'm not going to bring it all over from one side. Just a little here, and then a little over here. Just run through like this. Very nice and easy. No big worries. It's really very simple. Run the dirt on there, tamp it down real quick. And then I give it one more watering. And since I only put about maybe an inch worth of soil on here, I don't have to water too awful much. I just want to make sure that I get it good and wet. Not soaking, just wet, because we're going to come by every couple days and make sure that it's a little bit damp, not soaking, because you don't want your seeds sitting in soaking water. That'll help them rot, and we don't need any help getting them to rot. We want to keep them from not rotting. And that is it. That is absolutely all there is to planting corn as far as I'm concerned. There are different methods, of course, but this is my method, and we'll come back in about maybe a week or two and see how it's doing. Okay, for right now, I gotta finish up covering up the corn and watering it, but thanks for joining me for the corn planting episode. It's been the first time I've grown corn in, I don't know, a few years, so we'll see how it goes. Thanks everybody for joining me here in the garden. Have a great day. Bye.